Exactly 50 years after Proclamation 1081 or deposed President Ferdinand Marcos Sr.'s declaration of martial law, the statute's writer, then Justice Minister Juan Ponce Enrile, who now sits as President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s presidential chief legal counsel, maintains the Philippines is free and in a better situation because of martial law.
Hindi po nila makita yung wisdom nung pagkakatatag noong martial law noon na nagsagip sa ating kalayaan.
Dahil hindi kami madadaldal, quiet lang kami noon. Akala nila mandando na sila na ang hari. Pinabayaan lang namin. Kaya nung isang gabi nag-operate kami, sinarhan namin ang buong Pilipinas. Kinontrol ko ang komunikasyon, pati yung cable, lahat ng television station sinequester ko.
Enrile maintains martial law was declared to quash the growing force of CPP-NPA and other groups which allegedly enjoyed the support of some politicians. And given the continuous threat, he says, the power to declare martial law must solely be given to the sitting president as dictated by the 1973 Constitution. Enrile adds the words imminent danger must also return in the martial law provision along with rebellion and insurrection as basis for the declaration.
Kung nandyan na yung gerra, binabaril na yung mga sundalo ninyo, natin, at mga pulis, saka lang ako magdeklara ng martial law. Hindi pwede yun eh.
Enrile's attendance before the Senate Constitutional Amendments and Revision of Codes Committee was in relation to the discussion of two resolutions seeking charter change. Part of the former Senate President's suggestions was to scrap the entire 1987 Constitution and consider the 1935 and 1973 charters when drafting a new constitution. Enrile also believes increasing the senators to 48 with 16 to be elected every 2 years will ensure political stability. Enrile's suggestions, however, did not sit well with Senate Minority Leader Aquilino Coco Pimentel III. Pimentel's late father, Aquilino, was among the human rights victims during martial rule. Pimentel believes Marcos Sr. declared martial law for self-preservation and not because of rebellion.
Nabasa ko ron eh, ang feeling ni President Marcos siguro, only he could save the country. And that cannot be true. There would have been others who would have saved the Republic of the Philippines. And then we would have followed the Constitution. We would have also respected the will of the people kung who is that new leader that they wanted to elect in the scheduled election.
Other personalities who became activists during martial law meanwhile share their experiences.
Nalala ko, there was no rice noon. May kupon na binibigay ang nanay ko. Pipila ako para makabili ng bigas. Pipila ka, hindi hinihingi ah. Binibili mo isang ganda bawat pamilya for one day. Later on, ubos na yung bigas. After about 3 weeks, mais na yung binibenta.
The House of Representatives, albay Congressman Ed Selagman, whose brother Hermon never returned after his arrest on May 11, 1977, reminds the people to never forget history.
Remembering will make it more difficult to normalize violence and injustice. Remembering will help foreclose the propensity of people to turn a blind eye on official corruption and misconduct. Remembering is honoring the victims and survivors of martial law and celebrating their lives and sacrifices.
Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.